Christmas again. It's almost Christmas again. It's almost Christmas again. What a good time to get married. My Jesus and Joseph and Mary, Duncan and Kelly and all the fame. He's been Jehovah, though he's pretty scary enough to make one wary. It's almost Christmas again. It's almost Christmas again. It's almost Christmas again. What a good time to get married. It's almost Christmas again. It's almost Christmas again. Have a good time to get ready. It's almost Christmas again. Yeah, thank you.
We are.
Imagine such a thing.
Where did you go anyway?
I went and I had a sandwich.
Was it good?
Nope.
Did you bring me one?
Nope.
Good.
But welcome back to the Cape Cod Cavalcade Part 2, which should be at least as good or about as good as Part 1.
I've always loved Part 2.
Do you prefer Part 2s in general?
I do. I'm an even number kind of guy.
I find the Part 2s tend to dribble off sometimes.
Do you?
It's just when you're getting involved and they just go, well, I don't know what should happen here. I give up.
That's when you have three parts.
Oh, maybe that's the problem.
That's the thing. You got to stop with the second.
It's a problem with too many parts.
Too many parts.
Exactly. Yeah. Well, anyway, we're just going to, I mean, that was whatever we just saw there.
Oh,
I don't know what that was.
Brother, that was just, that was about as good as that's ever been.
Well, it was hard to identify. You know, I've seen things like this before, and now, and then sometimes you see them again.
If you're lucky.
If you're lucky.
Yeah.
It seems like the one thing that really has been missing from the Cavalcade so far...
I know what you're going to say, the juggling.
The juggling, exactly.
That's, how can we have a cavalcade without juggling?
And what brings more joy than Trevor the Juggler?
What indeed.
Then we've got the Ticks coming up with their version of the Christmas Carol, which is the Ben-Hur of cavalcade presentation.
With a chariot race and everything?
Well, I don't know about the chariot race, but I do think it's going to be very long.
No, I hope it has a chariot race. I love a good chariot race.
Well, I hope so too. Anyway, let's find out, shall we?
Thank you. nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior, born on Christmas Day, to save us all from Satan's time and gone astray. All tidings of comfort and joy.
Ah, humbug! Humbug! Glad tidings, Uncle Scrooge. God save you. I've come to visit you this Christmas Eve in your workplace on this bleak, bitter night to invite you to Christmas dinner tomorrow. You've not come to visit us these 7 years, not since your partner Jacob Marley passed away.
And I'll not come this year or next. Christmas dinner, humbug, humbug, I tell you. Do you know, if I was asked by some soft-headed do-gooders to donate a Christmas dinner to the poor, are there no prisons? Are there no workhorses, said I? Turn them away, turn them away, empty-handed. Heard the one mutter I was a squeezing, wrenching, scraping, clutching, covetous old sinner. Humbug, humbug.
Very well, Uncle. If you change your mind.
But isn't it bad enough, Cratchit? The custom dictates I must let you off for Christmas Day with pay. A poor excuse for picking a man's pocket every 25th of December.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. And Merry Christmas to you.
Humbug!
Scrooge! Scrooge!
Who's there? Who's there, I say?
Scrooge!
There. Who are you?
You must ask who I once was.
No, it cannot be. Jacob Marley, it cannot be you, gone these 7 years.
It is I, Jacob Marley, your old business partner. Doomed am I to walk the earth never ceasing. Bound by these chains I have forged in my lifetime, link by link. Chains of greed, chains of avarice.
No!
Yes, Scrooge, selfishness!
No, 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 spirit, be gone! Go and leave me! Come on, come on, that's all this is!
The same will be your fate, I portend!
Come on, that's all it is, a piece of undigested food.
Undigested food, am I? Listen to me, or cursed ye shall be. Tonight you shall be visited by spirits free. They come at the stroke of one, two, and three. Better listen to them. Lived a life of avarice, greed and total wants and selfishness. And if you don't want to walk the earth in chains, I guess you'll listen to my plea.
I must have dozed off. 1 o'clock has struck. No spirit plagues me there.
Ebenezer! Ebenezer! I am the ghost of Christmas past, here to show you shadows that once were.
No, no.
What? Would you so soon put out with worldly hands the light I give?
Sure.
Good answer. Look over there, Ebenezer. In that area. There you are as a young man. You are over there, Ebenezer, there you are as a young man. You're at a party thrown by your old former employer, old Fezziwig.
Old Fezziwig, he treated me as his son. What a festive party. Dancing, singing, merriment, and there's Belle. She was my fiancée at that time. So beautiful. Why are we not dancing with the others? What is it that I'm doing there?
24, 25, 26.
Oh, Ebenezer, why do you not join in the merriment with the others? Leave off your counting and celebrate Christmas.
27. In a moment.
Ebenezer, ever since the death of your beloved sister in childbirth, you have been so strange. You must stop blaming your nephew Fred for her death and dropping things and counting your purse. You must live.
38, 39, 40.
Ebenezer, I see there is a love that has replaced me in your heart. Nah.
Belle, come back, Belle.
Prisons? Are there no workhouses?
No comment. We didn't mean it.
I'm warning you.
Humbug!
Ghost. I guess you're telling them.
Oh, Ebenezer, come, let me show you.
No.
Let me show.
No.
Yes.
No.
Okay, go ahead.
No.
But
I just want to show you
what can happen on Christmas Day today. Come with me. I promise you that the scenes of Christmas past may have upset you, but it's all right. Yeah. I promise these scenes will be much more happy. Come. Look, Ebenezer, you see down there? Oh, isn't it wonderful? The miners sharing presents. And look at those townsfolk.
Look, in that lighthouse, party. Oh, with a rocking band.
Ah, yes, let's go down there.
And where are we now? Wait, I know
Ebenezer,
this house.
Ebenezer, yes, you do know this house. It's legal in Massachusetts now. This is the home of the Cratchit family. Come, let's look inside.
Sorry, Tim. Stay close by the fire now. You mustn't catch a chill.
Yes, my son. Don't let your excitement over Christmas wear you out. You need rest.
And now, a toast to the founder of the feast, Mr. Scrooge.
No, not him!
Oh, but my dears, it's Christmas.
That reveals it.
selfie of you and me. So happy as to be, put it on the wall so everyone can see it. If we're unhappy, no one will believe it. Maybe 100 people will like it. Oh, did I mention I also want peace on earth?
Tim live.
Oh, wait. Let me tell you about them later. I see a vacancy on the corner near the old chimney. If you disregard his cry, oh, then yes, the child.
Wait, put them back. Put them back for a minute.
Okay.
Just for a minute.
Really?
Yeah, just for a minute. Yeah. Just for a minute. Okay. This is my favorite line.
It's funny because it's true.
Say, what is that near your amplifier?
Oh, well, hold on a minute. Oh, my God. These are the children, like my own, that cling to me. I'm sorry about that. These are the children. Thank you. The boy is called want, and the girl is called ignorance, or vice versa. But beware the boy, for he has upon his brow, which is written doom, unless the writing be erased.
Is there anything that can be done for those children quickly?
Are there no prisons? Are there no workhouses? Are there no prisons? Are there no workhouses?
I was kidding.
Are there no prisons?
Can we get a little fog right here?
My servants, but what are they doing? My belongings, stealing them. And the undertaker too. Uh-oh. Oh, Oh, spirit, answer me this. Are these the shadows of things that must be, or are they the shadows of things that might be? I know that men's deeds foreshadow certain ends, but surely, if the deeds be departed from, the ends will change. Tell me it is so with what you show me now. No, tell me it is not so. I'm not the man I was. I'm not the man I was. Help me to smudge away the writing on the stone. Believe me, I'm not the man I was. I'm not the man I was. I'm not the man I was. Wait, you're doing my feet. What's going on? Tell me, what day is it?
Oh, it's Christmas Day!
Christmas Day? Christmas Day? It's Christmas Day?
Yeah!
It's Christmas Day! Merry Christmas and another shilling if you tell the butcher to bring a big fat turkey to the Clatchit household and tell him I have no choice but to raise his pay. I have not lost my senses, I've come to them. I hope you can forgive a poor, pig-headed old fool for having no eyes to see with and no ears to hear with all those long years. I must get to my nephew's house at once to celebrate. Merry Christmas, everyone! Merry Christmas!
Opening her eyes. As Joseph, second grader Douglas Trezor needed to be reminded that although his character did not technically impregnate the Virgin Mother, he should behave as though he were capable of doing so. As for the lighting, Sacred Heart Elementary chose to rely on nothing more than the flashbulbs ignited by those obnoxious stage mothers and fathers who had created those zombies, staggering back and forth across the linoleum floor dining hall. Under certain circumstances, parental pride is understandable, but it has no place in the theater.
Well, if you look, focus your life through the lens of barbiturates and whiskey and daily marijuana use and a third divorce, you too might put out a Christmas album.
Who cares about Michigan? Who cares about Michigan anymore? Merry Christmas!
wasn't it?
Oh, I really love that song. I don't know what it has to do with Christmas, but it's a wonderful song.
Well, it has everything to do with Christmas. You couldn't have Christmas without a...
Well, it does demonstrate very, very nicely how easy it is to turn a non-Christmas song into a Christmas song.
That's right.
And what do we have? What's happened? Where's my note? Where's my valet? What's happening?
What's happening? Well,
look who I'm asking.
You forgot, didn't you?
I have no idea what's happening. You know, the Christmas cheer is going quite well.
It is.
Yes.
It is.
What can we ask about who's on next?
Wait
a second. I've got notes down here where I can't see them. Oh, it's the Jingle Bells segment. It's the Jingle Bells segment.
Oh, my goodness.
It's the Jingle Bells segment.
This is just the best.
I love Jingle Bells.
Me too.
You can't play Jingle Bells enough as far as I'm concerned.
No, and ending every Christmas song with that little dee-dee.
Yes, everyone does that.
You got to do that.
I know.
Every single one.
I know. They should be shot, but in a nice way.
I even put it at the end of Ave Maria when I did
that.
Now that's class, isn't
that's, it? That's pretty paramount. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, the Jingle Bells segment.
Thank you.
Wow, that was something, huh?
It sure was.
Pierre Beauregarde.
Jingle Bells, best song ever.
I'm telling you.
What a man.
Don't get much better than that.
Than corn nuts.
Look what I got here, Danny.
I don't know what the hell that is. Uh-oh, I knocked over Godzilla.
I got my Yuletide septic of fun.
What? Whoa.
Look at that.
Oh, I didn't see that coming.
Yeah. Whoa. Look at that. Isn't that something?
Ah, you're making me very...
Now, that's just about as jolly as you're going to get.
You're making me a little uncomfortable.
Yeah, you know...
Would you hold that further away?
I'm trying to cast shadows.
Oh, it's so...
All on the ceiling and...
My, isn't that festive?
Make it look so festive and pretty in here. What do we got coming up next?
Well, we've got the Greenheads with Sarah Swain. I'm telling you.
Yeah.
It's time to dance. It's that thing at the end of the cavalcade where we always let it rip.
Okay.
And then we got Siobhan Magnus later on, too. Oh, my God.
So this is when you push your chairs aside, folks, and if you're sitting in it, be sure to get up first.
Well, he's right.
Silver bells, silver bells. It's Christmas time in the city. Ring a ring, ring and sing. Soon it will be Christmas Day.
Come on.
wasn't it?
I'm pretty sure it was. That was Siobhan Magnus, and she's fun.
She's always a lot of fun.
Yeah.
What do we got coming up next?
Well, so far we haven't had, I guess in part because it's Christmas, you tend to have less filth than you might ordinarily if you were in a barn or someplace like that.
That's true.
So we've got my good friends in Scream Along with Billy.
They're
going to give the favors a little birthday song. And then we've got the Catbirds.
Oh, my.
Yeah, the Catbirds who are loud. And then the Chandler Travis Philharmonic, who I've heard wonderful things about.
Well, I don't know.
Well, maybe. And then that's it for part two.
Good heavens.
I know.
How the time flies.
It does. It goes by so fast.
We'll have to do this again next year.
I suppose we will. I hope we get to do it with people next year would be my preference. I know.
You always want the moon, Daddy.
Exactly. Anyway, Merry Christmas from our family to your family and his family to his family.
Yeah, but not his family.
No.
Good night.
I'm still smiling.
Happy birthday.
Euphoria. Hey, how about that utopia?
man ain't no fool. And the children always happy, laughing and playing, playing and laughing. And God does all the work. All this while, the adolescent Jesus dancing to a brand new sound, dancing to a brand new sound, dancing to a brand new sound, dancing to a brand new sound. Christmas on earth, Christmas on earth, Christmas on earth.
Tuckered out. I want to tell you
what a night
this has been.
I've basically had it. Well, I am just pretty much in the bag.
But you know what, Danny?
No, I don't.
Well, I'm going to tell you then.
Oh.
We actually have a few more people who wanted to get in on the act and,
really?
And say hello to all our friends out there. Yes, indeed.
No kidding.
They sent in things special.
They sent things in special?
They sent in things special. Special delivery.
Oh, I heard John Pousette-Dart did something with his wife, Dawn, and I know there's some other folks in there, too. I think there's another John of some kind, if I recall correctly. But I have no way of knowing if that's true.
Well, that'll be lots of fun to see just who it is.
It very well may be. Let's see what pops up in this sort of mystery segment of Cavalcade or whatever.
Open the door for your mystery day.
He's singing. Well,
jingle bells, jingle bells on a one-horse open sleigh. Hey!
Merry Christmas!
Everybody, stay safe.
One, two, three.
Thank you for the music and the memories, Cavalcade. Merry Christmas!
Who did I forget on my Amazon list? Did I get everybody just the right kind of gift? Paper, the ribbon, the shopping songs, mail order catalog, it all seems so wrong. I hope I got something that somebody can use. And it got me a piece of these Christmas time blues. I love Thanksgiving, ain't too much pressure to show up with eggnog, night and pleasure. Old friends and family have all given thanks. But Christmas looks like it was created by Max. Is it gilt or green? I'm gonna wait for blue. Just on the sleigh bells, can't hear myself. I got the Christmas time blues. Happy birthday, Jesus. I need a drink. Just up some sleigh bells, can't hear myself. Think I got the Christmas time blues. Happy birthday, Jesus. I need a drink. My cars are maxed out, and so is my wallet. An emotional time of the year, they call it. My savings are gone to lay away my best friend. Maybe by July, his blues fall again. From my snow-capped crown down on my high shoes, and brought me a Jesus. Just not the sleigh bells, can't hear myself. Think I got the Christmas time blues. Happy birthday, Jesus. I need a drink. Got the Christmas time blues. Happy birthday.
everyone's happy there. It's more than a girl and a boy land, where dreams just like toys can be shared. If you believe in Toyland, believe in things that you cannot see. All the world will become such a joyland. What a wonderful world this will be. Please take me back to Toyland. Everyone's happy there. All the world will become a joyland. What a wonderful world this would be.
Humans will be able to take your muzzles off so you can smell things again and sniff your friends and stuff, okay? So, Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas from McLean's studio right here in Orleans. I hope you all have a really safe and happy holiday.
The Christmas trees are killing me. I have bruises on my arms, and I have scratches on my hands, and my feet hurt. I know there's not deadly pesticides on them really, cause they're young trees, but you know, who the heck cares anyhow? It's a dead, dead, dead tree. Oh yeah. The only good Christmas tree is a dead Christmas tree. Kill 'em all, let God sort 'em out. Why do they hurt me? They hurt me so. Stop, 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 stop hurting me. Oh yeah, baby. Bum 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 bum. stop, 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 stop hurting me. The Christmas trees are killing me. I have bruises on my arms, and I have scratches on my hands.
We would so much rather be jingling your bells in person. All right, do it again, do it again. Happy Hanukkah. Will Hanukkah be over? Merry Christmas from Billy and Sue. Try it again. One more. Fuck this.
C'est bon de partir n'importe où. Bras dessous, en chantant des chansons. C'est bon de se dire des mots doux, de petits rien de tout, mais qui en disent long, en voyant notre mine ravie. Les passants dans la rue nous envient. C'est si bon de guetter dans ses yeux un espoir merveilleux qui donne le frisson. C'est si bon, les petites sensations, ça vaut mieux qu'au million. C'est tellement, tellement bon. Voilà, c'est bon. Les passants dans la rue, bras dessus, bras dessous, en chantant des chansons. Quel espoir merveilleux. C'est bon.
Happy holidays from Pamela and Richard.
I don't know what's around or what's right.
Swain.